Okay. So, hi everyone. I'm Aleko Sfilini. I'm a developer at Blockstream, and today I'm going to be talking about peer-to-peer payments in gaming, specifically in poker, in this case. I'm here in the gaming section, but actually the focus of my presentation is not really about gaming, but more about the underlying like technology that you can use to do these kind of cool tricks. But I feel like showing a game that most people know, at least, it's like a good way to have a feeling for what's happening. It's not just theoretical words, but it's something you can kind of feel. So this is like a brief overview. First of all, I'm going to be talking about how payments are routed in Lightning, not anything technical, just an overview. Then how we can use the routing of payments of Lightning to build oracles on Lightning, how we can use those oracles to build a poker game on Lightning, and things that can be improved. And also, I will try to leave some time for questions, because there might be some. So first of all, I'm not going to go into the technical details because it's late, we're all tired, but just to kind of recap, this is pretty important to understand. So in Lightning, whenever we try to route a payment, we're not there's no way for us to force other people to route our payments. We can just ask them to do so. We generally offer a fee, so there's an incentive for other nodes to route our payments, but there's no way to force them. They could just refuse to do so. And this might, in a way, feel like a shortcoming of the Lightning protocol, but I feel like it's actually pretty useful in many use cases, like this one. So the fact that the payment is not, there's like a transitional phase between when it's initiated, it's in a pending phase, when it goes through all the nodes, and then it can either complete or fail on the other end. And we can use that to build what I would call basically oracles on Lightning. So every node that is part of a route can act actually as an oracle. It can basically, what normally happens is that a node, if it's online, it wants to take the fee, and so it's just gonna route the payment in no time. But actually what we could do is we could add a little bit of a delay in every step, and so the node could wait for the outcome of an event and then act as an oracle and say, okay, I'm gonna let this payment through, or maybe make it fail. So think, for instance, to this pretty simple example. Maybe there are two people betting on an event. They can pay each other, and the very important thing is that they both pay each other through this oracle, which is actually a trusted party in this protocol. So it's not a trustless thing, but just a pretty cool trick. The oracle waits for the outcome of the event and then can decide, okay, this payment will go through, this other will fail, or vice versa, based on basically who won the bet. And we can use this, basically just extend it a little bit, to build the poker game. So Lightning Poker is this little project I threw together. It's like literally not production ready or anything, just hackathon level, I would say, but it works. And basically, we do like the very dumb thing, which is whenever a player places a bet, so it could be at the beginning of the game, there are the blinds betting, or maybe when a player calls or raises, they are basically sending a payment to all the other players at the table. So the server coordinates that, the server asks for an invoice to everybody. Here, spontaneous payment would actually help quite a lot. So the server asks for an invoice to everybody else, send invoices to the player will pay all of them, and the server makes sure that this is happening, because the server is also the oracle, is also the node in between those routes of all those payments. So the server will basically wait for them to finish. People can obviously bet multiple times, this is not a matter, it's just, there's a pretty high limit to how many HTLCs can be attached to the transaction, so people can bet like hundreds of times, this is not a big deal. We will just wait for the end to finish, and then the server will decide who won, who lost, make all the payment to the winner go through, and block all the others. So basically the end result is that the winner will get his money that he won, all the others will have paid the winner, and all the other payments between losers will be cancelled. And again, this is not trustless, so the server could do bad stuff, it could make some payment that should not go through. So the server is a trusted entity in this sense, but the cool thing is that you are never like depositing money on the server, so it's just, you're trusting the server to play the game in a fair way, basically, not to trust him with your own money because you are paying in a peer-to-peer way all the other players in the room. So I wanted to show like a real demo, but unfortunately my laptop doesn't work with this projector, so I swear it works, so if you're interested, you can just come to me, I will show you the real thing. This is a video, like a screen cap of my phone. Yeah, just like to understand maybe the context a little bit better. In this case, I have an Eclair wallet on my phone, but it's actually a patched version of Eclair. So this patched version basically starts a web server in background. It's like unsafe, unsecured, no password, it just... I said earlier this is an hackathon level project, so it was just threw together. But this web server allows other web pages to ask the Eclair node to make payments or to create invoices. So this is what's happening in background. The full node is running on the phone actually, but it's like hidden from the user. So I will try to make this full screen. Maybe I will pause a couple of times just to explain everything a little bit better. So. Okay, so this is like the beginning. This is my transaction list. As you can see, this SDKJ test transaction is the last one. So this is gonna be like a reference for at the end of the video when I will come back to this. Now we can switch to the browser where there's the game. The game was mostly like optimized for mobile screens, but it can work obviously on desktop and everywhere else. Just a matter of doing CSS a little bit better than I actually did. And there's also another player on the other side which is not shown. So both players said they're ready, so the round starts. We want to like accumulate a bit of money so that we can see the payments later. So our player will call now. And this little action, actually even before he clicked this button, just the fact that the player said it was ready meant that there was a payment. Initially it was a 50 Satoshi bet. So even at this time, nobody has done anything. There's already a pending payment of 50 Satoshi from this player to the other one, and a payment of 100 Satoshi from that player to this other one, which means that even if one of the two players backs out, so stops playing, these are money that they already bet, and they are going to go to the actual winner of the round. So now this, like us, our player will call. Now it's the other player's turn. I think it's going to raise, probably. Yeah, he raised to 200, and we're going to call just to make the pot grow a little bit. And then it's like a normal Texas Hold'em game, so I think they keep checking. They just let the round finish. So they're both checking. So the pot is 400. Both players, they put 200 Satoshi each. And this is the final final move. So now this is the end of the game. Our player won. I think it was, he had like a, I don't know the exact term, like a 5, 6, 7, something like that. Our player won, so we are expecting a 200 Satoshi payment to come in to our node. So we will switch back to the Eclair node. Oh, actually, no, we can already see the notification from Eclair. But if we open the app, which is going to happen pretty soon, you can see all the payments that they were done basically in background. So there are two payments that came in successfully, and it's 100 Satoshi each. So it's a total of 200 Satoshi that we received. There are a few payments that failed, specifically like these three payments, which were the first 50 Satoshi we bet as a for the small blind, then another 50 for the first call, and then another 100 for the last call we did. And all these payments failed because we won. So these were payments that were directed to the other player, but since he lost, those payments were canceled, and we just received our own money. And I think this is like this is a cool thing in a way, but there are still a lot of issues that could be improved. So one thing that we could improve is split up payments to allow for more complex outcomes. So right now, whenever we whenever there's a split pot case, which is kind of rare, but it can happen in poker. We just cancel all the round, but we could do something more complicated by, instead of sending like 100 Satoshi payment, sending 10,000 Satoshi payments, so that we can like say, okay, this player are gonna receive 30 Satoshis and this other one 70, we can split it in a more complex way. And we could also have like extension to like the Lightning protocol. This would require probably having a direct channel with the server, but I don't think this is that bad. Like it could be, instead of depositing money on chain to a gaming server, we could open a channel with this gaming server once, and then use all these extensions that we both understand and have like reuse the liquidity. So instead of sending 5 payments to 5 people, we can just send 1 payment that the server is gonna split in 5 by changing the HLC a little bit and maybe some other improvements. So once again, this was not really about poker. I think this just this idea that we can have oracles on Lightning, I think it's pretty cool, even for like financial application, for some kind of smart contract application. And this poker thing, I think, is just a pretty cool way to see it, like, and so on. And this is it. If I have time, I will accept questions. Otherwise, yeah, that's it. Thank you.
So does the Oracle assume that the route will work to the...
Right. This is it? Yeah. So it's basically the player responsibility to pay through the node. This is like to pay through the server node. This is like a first challenge. And what I do here is just that I embed routing ints into invoices so that I'm sure that the nodes are going to pay like that. And then I think you maybe meant after the node. So like the payments arrive to the node. Yeah, this is an issue. Like in this specific project, it's not really addressed. I think we should maybe try to probe payments. So just to make sure that once I say, okay, this payment can go through, that it can really reach the final destination. So this is a pretty big issue that should be solved for that. Once again, this would be mitigated by having direct channels with the server, which, I mean, it's a, in a way, it's like a centralized model, but I don't think it's so bad. It's just a gaming server, you open a channel with this gaming server to play, and if you have direct channels, if both players have direct channels, the server can know, like, is the other peer online? Is there enough liquidity? So the server can make some more checks just to make sure that, okay, I'm going to accept this payment because I know for sure it's gonna finish, it's going to complete. So yeah, there are a few challenges, but I think it can be done in a pretty cool way if you accept some centralization trade-off, which I don't think it's any bad in this specific case.
Hey, awesome. Any last questions? All right, let's give him a round of applause. Thank you so much.
Thank you.